Hey everyone, I hope you're having a fantastic day today. I wanted to talk a little bit about this new information that has come out regarding this fake meat company that produces vegan meat products called the Impossible Burger from Impossible Foods. So if you are a vegetarian, if you're vegan, or if you're looking to cut out meat, this is very important to listen to because this company, if you're aware of this company at all, a lot of their food comes from restaurants. One company is Impossible Foods, which makes the Impossible Burger. And then the other company is Beyond Meat, which is one you can actually buy in various restaurants as well as actually buy in the grocery store. Now, this isn't about Beyond Meat, but Beyond Meat is certainly a lot better in this regard because their product is not genetically modified. Beyond Meat's product is actually non-GMO. But the Impossible Burger, which uses genetically modified yeast to make heme iron, and now they're using genetically modified soy, their burger was recently tested positive for glyphosate, which is a carcinogenic herbicide that is widely used, probably the most widely used herbicide. So glyphosate can only be used on conventional crops. And with genetically modified soy, it is resistant to glyphosate, so large amounts can be sprayed on it. There are many issues when it comes to genetic modification of various foods. And with soy products, the Impossible Burger, it used to be made from wheat gluten, and now it's made from soy. So if you have a wheat allergy or a soy allergy, this really isn't the best for you. So on that end, Beyond Meat is also far superior because they have neither wheat, gluten, or soy in their formula. With the Impossible Burger, it being made with genetically modified soy protein now, in this article here, 11 times higher than that of the Beyond Meat Burger. So it came to 11.3 parts per billion. Because glyphosate is an endocrine disrupting chemical, it doesn't matter how small of amount is in the product. It should not be there at all, first of all, because it is a pesticide. And second, it is an endocrine disruptor, so it does damage to the gut when you consume it, and it does damage to the endocrine system. So it's not intended to be consumed. It's meant for the actual farming process, but they can't remove it all. With organic foods, you're not going to have that. So that's the Beyond Meat one is not organic, but it doesn't use genetically modified food, so it's not going to have that amount of glyphosate on it. This is a major problem because the company states that the glyphosate in their product is far below the level of what it is acceptable. And the thing is, there is no acceptable level. I even tweeted about this, and the company even replied saying that they prioritize safety and health above all else, saying, we test our key ingredients and finished products for pesticides, including glyphosate, to ensure that pesticides are absent or far below the level that are accepted as safe by regulatory agencies. Then they link this article, which is essentially just very angry. It's a very angry comeback. Which honestly, it's a very, I would say, very unprofessional way of going about things. And they put a lot of misinformation in there regarding not only genetically modified foods, but what the organization that they're attacking, Moms Across America, is actually doing. So they go on about that. And so I was like, you know, I'm definitely not going to buy this product now. This is not a product that I'm going to stand behind. Another issue with this is that the heme iron that is in it, heme iron is found in animal products, and that's how they use the yeast, the modified yeast, to be able to produce this heme iron. Heme iron in itself can be cancer-causing as well. So that is, again, another issue there. Now, this is really important because recently, Monsanto, which is now owned by Bayer, had another case here where they have to pay $2 billion because they found that Roundup causes cancer for this couple. Now, obviously, it's not fully complete yet. I'm sure this amount, when it's fully settled, will go down tremendously. But that was what the initial price was, $2 billion. And as always, Bear always comes back with saying that we are disappointed with the jury's decision and will appeal the verdict in this case. And they go on saying that glyphosate-based products can be used safely and that glyphosate is not carcinogenic, and the 40 years of extensive scientific research on which their favorable conclusions are based. There is really no evidence to support what they're saying, because most of the evidence that is there and the scientific studies that have been done from the companies who have made the product. This is the third or fourth major lawsuit that has come forward regarding glyphosate causing cancer. So that is just spraying it. That's not consuming it. So when you consume it, I'd imagine it would be much worse for you, because you're consuming it daily. Even if you eat organic, even if you eat all natural foods, you're still going to consume a small amount of it. Okay, it's far better than the conventional foods and consuming them and the genetically modified foods, but you're still going to do it. So while the Impossible Burger, I mean, it is great what they're doing, trying to get people to get off the meat products and cause less harm to animals and to the planet. On the other end, they're essentially destroying the planet with their glyphosate products and making people unhealthy with glyphosate. And if you're in a restaurant and there's a veggie burger there, you know, ask them what brand it is. Ask them if they know what a brand it is, or if you can even request the Beyond Meat burger as opposed to the Impossible Burger because of the glyphosate and the genetic modification. That would be ideal. So let me know your thoughts on this. This is something that I'm very passionate about, people's health, healing, and just getting to the root of what's going on here. So I do not approve of this. I mean, as I said, I stand behind their mission of veganism, but I do not stand behind a mission of genetic modification or microdosing glyphosate in their products, okay? So you take care, and I will catch you all later. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.